Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We all have friends in our lives, some who celebrate us and all of our successes, and some who don't express as much genuine excitement or support. I think we can all agree that sometimes people have a hard time being happy for others when they are unhappy themselves. Mm-hmm. Does this make someone a bad friend or just a friend going through a difficult point in their lives while seeing someone else flourish in areas that they aren't? Ladies, have you ever been that friend and not even noticed? Or have you experienced this with another friend, and how did you deal with that? I see you are shaking your head.
Well, I had this girl growing up my whole life, and my sisters, you guys know who she is. Cindy. And we were like always, she was my best friend of me. And we were always in competition. And it was kind of good but kind of bad, but because of each other, we were like, okay, who has the best grades? Who has the longest hair? Who has the cutest boyfriend? Things like that.
Yes.
And I think she kind of helped me in a way because I had to be better than her and she had to be better than me. You know what I mean? And it's not a healthy relationship at all.
Clearly.
It isn't. But we would always, you know, stay over each other's houses. But because she's like one of the only people my parents would let us stay over each other's houses. It was real, you know, strict, little bit.
So where is Cindy, friend now?
She's married.
Okay, good. Okay.
To a doctor.
Okay.
She's doing well.
Okay, good. Okay. The relationship ended badly.
It did. Let me tell you something.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I didn't want to go there, but I'm gonna go there.
You're fine. You had a whole national TV show.
Her, so when we finally found a touch, and then we got back in touch, then we finally did Braxton Family Values. I was like, oh my gosh, we have this new TV show coming out. It's called Braxton Family Values. Blah, 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 blah. Whenever we come in town, I would love for you to guest spot with us on the show. So after we did like the first season, she called me. She was like, well, you know, I saw the first few episodes and I just don't think that your show is something for me.
Oh.
I said, well.
Well, girl, you could have kept your opinion to yourself. I didn't
need you to call me.
It's
okay though.
Yeah.
At least she's honest.
Yeah.
It was her truth.
Yeah, it was her truth.
It was her truth.
And that was her way of saying
that she's
I'm not good
inside.
Enough.
No, that's her way of saying I'm seething inside.
Oh, well, then there's that. Then there's that. And then you just gotta let those people dissipate in your lives. I love to celebrate people, honey.
I do.
I just do. And I think, you know, we've had a couple of conversations that have geared toward this. I just love to see people win. I can see a stranger win. I'm like, oh my God, that's a, I literally was down to some girl's page. Not some girl. a girl that I follow down to the Instagram. Her name is Summer. She does like the brows, and she just got this brand new white Range Rover. She probably said, girl, do your thing. Why would I be mad? Because I want the same car, but I don't want the red interior like she does. You know what I'm saying? But I wanted to celebrate her because I know what you put out, you get right back.
Exactly.
I celebrate her. What's up, Summer? Do your thing.
Sis. Yes.
I like to see people win.
Me too.
Now, I don't know who may be jealous of me or whatever. But they don't come to my face. They might be hating from the side. I don't care. I don't talk. I don't post no meme about it. I'm doing this for my haters. You want the hater won because you posted the meme.
Yeah,
okay.
I
can't stand those type of memes. It's the worst thing you could ever do.
You gave them energy.
You gave them energy.
Sure. I don't give the people.
So I love to see people win. We win, and we all win.
We all win. I have had people like that. Multiple people like that throughout my life. And just it'd be family, friends, and they're always there. They're never gonna go away. And they'll just be like, oh, that's good, what you doing? You know, it's a whole bunch of them. Girl, I like you, but then stabbing you behind your back. You know, you have friends that be, or just people that say they like you and say they want you to do well, and then behind their back, they steal your contacts and all kind of
food.
You introduce them to people, they go and they be like, oh, okay, and then they go steal your contacts.
Oh, they want your whole team. Come on, Lena.
I'm just saying, it's people. And as celebrities, I know you guys are being nice, but there are people like that that we can't shake, unfortunately. And you know what? The question is it because they're just hateful people or they're having a bad time in their life? I say this to that. Well, basically what Rashawn said, you can't give them energy, that's first of all, because you never know what people are going through in their lives. But even if you're going through something in your life, that doesn't give you permission to speak death or spew hate on someone else's life.
Go ahead,
wish bad on someone else. And it's okay to be envious, but there's a fine fine line between envy and jealousy.
You don't know their struggle.
Yeah. Well, you don't know that person's story. Yeah. While you thinking they doing their thing, you don't know how hard they work for what they do and what they're going through.
I'm going to close it out with my one minute and 30 seconds, and I don't mean me very much because Lena spoke well.
Go ahead.
But I will tell you this. I have had friends, one whom I still consider to be a friend. Mm. We went to school together. I met her in eighth grade, okay? And one whom I will never fool with a day again in my life because she wants to destroy me.
Mm-hmm. And I know who that
every
is.
Every time. With all of her breath and being, she consistently tries to destroy me, but she fails miserably. It's okay as long as Quad was successful, but Miss Quad cannot be more successful than me.
Ooh, that's the same
person.
And so
I will never fool with that woman again in life, and she is a habitual liar. Now, I'm going to leave her there because I don't have the time for it. My other friend... Oh. She fell into a situation, made some poor decisions, and had to suffer some consequences behind it. In that time of need, I stepped up for her, opened my home up to her, and everything else that I had. Mm. Love her to death to this day. She's my eighth grade friend, and then asked me to go to college with her because she did not want to go alone. Mm. I said yes because I had gotten accepted too.
Oh, yes. Yeah,
okay.
Fine.
So there was a time where I had more. Mm-hmm. And she told me that one day she just out the blue called me and said, hey, I was jealous of you during this time. Although you were the lender, I was jealous because I was not the lender and I was the borrower.
Ooh. But that's good
and
she said
what?
It.
I respect her
yes,
so
that's
much.
That's good.
I love her you so much person. For it. Yeah. And I told her, you know what? It's okay. You're whole
yeah,
now. That baby
courage,
went back and
love.
Turned up with her life. Got a master's. She's married. She has children. And she is beautiful. She is my homegirl in Memphis. And I love you.
All right, love it.
Yay.
That's how you end the segment. Tell us how you feel about your friends or your not so much so friends.
We'll be right back.